Good morning. What are the objectives of this video lesson? That means on completion of this period, this video lesson, you would be able to know what is rubber, sources of rubber, structure of rubber. Okay, next. Processing of natural rubber from latex. Flowchart of processing of rubber. Okay, next. Vulcanization of rubber, process of vulcanization, structure of vulcanized rubber. Okay, what are the different materials used in automobiles? One is metals, plastics, glass, rubber. All these materials are used in the automobiles. Okay, metals, plastics, glass, rubber. All these materials are used in the automobiles. Okay, what is the material used in the manufacture of tires and tubes in cycles and automobiles? Okay, what is the material used in the manufacture of tires and tubes in cycles and automobiles? That is rubber. Okay, rubber is used in the manufacture of tires and tubes in cycles and automobiles. Okay, rubber is used. Okay, now we discuss about rubber. First one, sources of rubber. Second one, structure of rubber. One is sources of rubber, another one is structure of rubber. Okay, first we discuss about rubber. What are the sources of rubber? Okay, sources of rubber is two types. One is natural source, another one is artificial source. Rubber is prepared by natural source or artificial source. Okay, first natural source of rubber. We discussed about natural source of rubber. What is the natural source of rubber? Generally, rubber is prepared from trees. Rubber is obtained from trees. So which trees give rubber? Hevea brasiliensis, gutta percha, balata. These trees gives rubber material. Okay, generally rubber is prepared from these trees: Hevea brasiliensis, gutta percha, balata. Okay, first we discuss about natural rubber. Generally, rubber obtained from natural source is called natural rubber. Okay, rubber is obtained from natural source like trees. Okay, Hevea brasiliensis or gutta percha balata. The type of rubber is called natural rubber. Okay. Rubber is obtained from natural source like trees is called natural rubber. This rubber contains heavy molecular weight. This is a organic polymer. Rubber is a heavy molecular weight organic polymer. This is the polymer of isoprene. What is the isoprene means? 2-methyl-1,3-butadiene. 2-methyl-1,3-butadiene is isoprene. Okay. Generally, rubber is prepared from isoprene. Isoprene is a 2-methyl-1,3-butadiene. Okay. Rubber obtained from natural source is called natural rubber. High molecular weight organic polymer. Polymer of isoprene. Isoprene is 2-methyl-1,3-butadiene. Okay, this is the isoprene structure. Isoprene is the 2-methyl-1,3-butadiene. Okay, 2-methyl-1,3-butadiene. This is the organic substance. Okay, you write this chain contain 4 carbons. Okay, listen. This chain contain 4 carbons. This is the chain. contain four carbons, that is one, this is two, this is three, this is the fourth. Okay, one, two, three, four. The second carbon contain methyl. Next, first carbon contain double bond. Third carbon contain double bond. That's why, which carbons contain double bond? First and third carbons. Which carbon contain methyl group? This is the methyl group, second carbon. So 2 methyl, 1 comma 3, 4 carbons. So buta, 2 double bonds, diene. 2 methyl, 1 comma 3 buta, diene. 2 methyl, 1 comma 3 buta, diene is a isoprene. This is the formula. CH2 double bond, C single bond, CH double bond, CH2 second carbon contain methyl group. So 2 methyl, 1 comma 3 buta diene is a isoprene. Okay, structural formula of isoprene is like this. Okay, that means isoprene molecules, that means 2 methyl, 1 comma 3 buta diene molecules undergo addition polymerization and form polyisoprene. This polyisoprene is called natural rubber. Okay, more number of isoprene units present in the polyisoprene, that polyisoprene is called rubber. So this polyisoprene or rubber is prepared by the addition polymerization of isoprene or 2 methyl 1 comma 3 butadiene. This is the structural formula of natural rubber. CH2 bond, C double bond, CH bond, CH2, CH3. Discuss about processing of natural rubber from latex. Generally, natural rubber is obtained from latex. What is the latex means? Latex is a milky colloidal liquid or solution. Latex is a milky colloidal liquid or solution. Latex is obtained from trees like Hevea brasiliensis. This is the Hevea brasiliensis tree. Latex is a milky colloidal solution. Latex is obtained from trees like Hevea brasiliensis. Okay. This latex is collected by making incisions in the bark of rubber trees. Latex is collected by cutting of the bark of rubber trees or making incisions in the bark of rubber trees. Latex is collected by cutting in the bark of rubber trees or making incisions in the bark of rubber trees. Generally, tapping is done at an interval of about 6 months. Tapping is done of the trees at an interval of about 6 months. Okay, listen. Natural rubber is obtained from latex. What is the latex means? Latex is a milky colloidal solution. This latex is collected by cutting in the bark of rubber trees. This tapping is done on the trees at an interval of about 6 months. Okay. This latex is diluted with water to eliminate any dirt. Okay. When tapping is done on tree, some milky liquid is come, that is taken in the vessels. That is the milky colloidal solution that is diluted with the water. If any dirt is there in the latex, that dirt is eliminated by adding of water. Okay, listen. Latex is a milky colloidal solution. Latex is obtained from trees like Hevea brasiliensis. Latex is collected by making incisions or cutting of trees in the bark of rubber trees. Okay, this type of tapping is done on the trees at an intervals of about 6 months. After obtaining latex that is diluted, why? Because any dirt is present in the latex, that dirt is eliminated by adding of water. Okay, after obtaining latex from trees, some preservatives like ammonia is added to the latex. Okay, after obtaining latex from trees, preservative like ammonia is added to the latex. After that, coagulants like acetic acid and formic acid is added to the latex. Then rubber particles are coagulated. This is obtained, rubber is obtained as white dug-like mass. This is called coagulamin. It then milled and sheeted to remove contains contaminants and allow drying. Then crude rubber is obtained. Okay, after obtaining of latex from trees, preservatives like ammonia is added to the latex. After that, coagulants like acetic acid and formic acid are added to latex. Then rubber particles are coagulated. Those are white and dug-like mass. That is called coagulum. That rubber then milled and sheeted to remove contaminants and allow drying. Then crude rubber is obtained. Okay, flow chart of processing of latex. Okay, listen. Latex is a milky colloidal solution. It is obtained from tree like Hevea brasiliensis. Okay, this latex is obtained by making incisions in the bark rubber trees. The type of tacking is done on the trees at the intervals of 6 months. Some white liquid is come from trees that is taken in the vessels. That white liquid is called latex. After obtaining latex from the trees, some water is added. Any dirt particles present in the latex, those dirt particles are eliminated by adding of water. So that latex contains 15 to 20% remaining is water. After that, preservatives like ammonia is added to the latex. After that, coagulants like acetic acid and formic acid is added to the latex. Then rubber particles can be coagulated from the latex. That is called coagulum. That is filter and rolling, then natural crude rubber is obtained. This is the flow chart of processing of latex. After the processing of latex, natural crude rubber is obtained. Okay, what is the monomeric unit present in the natural rubber? Already just we have discussed, that is isoprene. Another name is 2-methyl-1,3-butadiene. That formula is C5H8. What is the monomeric unit present in the natural rubber? Means isoprene units present in the natural rubber. Isoprene formula is C5H8. That is 2-methyl-1,3-butadiene. Just we have discussed. Next, we discuss about vulcanization. So what is the vulcanization? The process of heating the raw rubber or crude rubber with sulfur at 110 to 140 degrees centigrade is called vulcanization. the process of heating the rubber with sulfur at 110 to 140 degree centigrade is called vulcanization. This definition is very, very important. This temperature limit is also important, that is 110 to 140 degree centigrade. Which material is added to the rubber? Sulfur is added to the rubber. Okay, the process of heating the rubber with sulfur at 110 to 140 degree centigrade is called vulcanization. Okay, sulfur combines at the double bonds of different rubber springs. Okay, when sulfur is added to the rubber, that sulfur combines at the double bond of different rubber springs. Okay, this process stiffens the material and prevents intermolecular movement of rubber springs. Okay, the process of heating the rubber with sulfur at 110 to 140 degree centigrade is called vulcanization. Generally, sulfur combines at the double bonds of different rubber springs. This process stiffens the material and prevents intermolecular movement of rubber springs. Okay, we see the reaction. We take, this is the rubber. Okay, rubber contain this isoprene units. Okay, this is one. Add sulfur and heat 110 to 140 degree centigrade. This sulfur combines with the double bond carbons here, and also here. Then rubber will be vulcanized. Okay, we take rubber and add sulfur and heat 110 to 140 degree centigrade. This sulfur combines at the double bond of carbons. Okay, we just have seen, listen. We take rubber and add sulfur and heat 110 to 140 degree centigrade. Then sulfur combines double bond of carbons. So this two carbons contain double bond, this two carbon contain double bond. This double bond is broken. Then in the place of double bond, this sulfur is added between these two carbon. Next, here also these two carbons contain double bond, these two carbons contain double bond. Here also double bonds are broken. Then sulfurs combine between these two carbons. This is the vulcanized rubber structure. We take this one unit, you take this here one unit. Here double bond present. Here double bonds are broken. Then sulfurs are present between these two carbons. This is the vulcanized rubber structure. Okay, this is the vulcanized rubber. Then after that, it gives sulfur cross links vulcanized rubber. Okay, next we discuss about the properties of vulcanized rubber depends on how much amount of sulfur is added in the vulcanization, how much temperature is maintained at which vulcanized rubber is carried out. Next, duration of vulcanization. The properties of vulcanized rubber depends on the amount of sulfur used in the vulcanization, how much temperature is maintained at which vulcanized rubber is carried out. Next, duration of vulcanization. The properties of vulcanized rubber depends on amount of sulfur used, the temperature at which it is carried out. Next, duration of vulcanization. Next, we discuss about characteristics of natural rubber or raw rubber. It is soft at high temperature and brittle at low temperature. Tensile strength is only 200 kg per centimeter square. That means it can large water absorption capacity, non-resistant to non-polar solvent like benzene, carbon, tetrachloride. That means that raw rubber is dissolved in this solvents are attacked by oxidized agent like H2SO4, HNO3, etc. Here rubber is attacked by oxidized agents like H2SO4, HNO3, etc. Swells considerably in organic solvents, easily spoiled due to oxidation. When stretched greater extent, it suffers permanent deformation. Next, little durability. Okay. Raw rubber is soft at high temperature and brittle at low temperature. That means if temperature is used high, raw rubber will be soft. If temperature is used low, raw rubber will be brittle. And next, tensile strength is only 200 kilograms per centimeter square. That means the rubber will have 200 kgs weight in matrame tattukogalutadi. Antakante ekkuva indante it will be brittle. Next, raw rubber absorbs large water. That means that is not good character of raw rubber. Next, non-resistant to non-polar solvents like benzene, carbon tetrachloride, etc. This type of non-polar solvents, benzene, carbon tetrachloride, no, dan meeda rubber pai unchinatlayite adi tattukoledu. Next, idi oxidizing agents ainatundi H2SO4, HNO3 tho kuda attack avutundi. Next, organic solvents lopala idi swell avutundi. నెక్స్ట్ ఆక్సిడేషన్ ద్వారా ఇది స్పాయిల్ అవుతుంది ఈజీలీ రా రబ్బర్ ఈజీలీ స్పాయిల్డ్ డ్యూ టు ఆక్సిడేషన్ నెక్స్ట్ వెన్ స్ట్రెచ్డ్ గ్రేటర్ ఎక్స్టెంట్ ఇట్ సఫర్స్ పర్మనెంట్ డిఫర్మేషన్ దీనిపైన ఎక్కువ స్ట్రెచ్చింగ్ ఫోర్స్ వచ్చినట్లయితే దానికి ఫార్మేషన్ చేంజ్ అవుతుంది అది అట్లే ఆ ఫార్మేషన్ అట్లే ఉండిపోతుంది ది లిటిల్ డ్యూరబిలిటీ దీని డ్యూరబిలిటీ ఈజ్ ఆల్సో వెరీ లెస్ దీస్ ఆర్ ద క్యారెక్టరిస్టిక్స్ ఆఫ్ న్యాచురల్ రబ్బర్ Soft at high temperature and brittle at low temperature. Tensile strength is only 200 kilograms per centimeter square. Next, large water absorption capacity. No resistant to non-polar solvents like benzene, carbon tetrachloride, etc. Next, attacked by oxidizing agents like H2SO4, HNO3, etc. Next, swells considerably in organic solvents. Easily spoiled due to oxidation. When stretched to greater extent, it suffers permanent deformation, little durability. Okay, next we discuss about characteristics of vulcanized rubber. Just we have discussed characteristics of raw rubber. Next we discuss about characteristics of vulcanized rubber. Okay, it has good tensile strength, that is 2000 kilograms per centimeter square. That means rubber pen 2000 kilograms per centimeter square weight inchina kuda that rubber tattukogalutundi rubber anetundi tattukogalutundi anta weight inchina kuda tattukogalutundi that means rubber vulcanized rubber has good tensile strength that is 2000 kilograms per centimeter square next low water absorption capacity rubber manam water lo unchinatledi takku water ni absorb chestundi this is the low water absorption capacity నెక్స్ట్ బెటర్ ఎలక్ట్రికల్ ఇన్సులేటర్ ఇది మనకు రా రబ్బర్తో కంపేర్ చేసినట్లయితే బెటర్ ఎలక్ట్రికల్ ఇన్సులేటర్గా వర్క్ చేస్తుంది జనరల్ రబ్బర్ని కూడా ఆల్ రబ్బర్స్ ఆర్ ఎలక్ట్రికల్ ఇన్సులేటర్స్ నెక్స్ట్ వర్కింగ్ టెంపరేచర్ ఈజ్ -40 to 100 degrees centigrade ఈ రబ్బర్ను -40 degrees centigrade తీసుకెళ్ళినా బ్రిటిల్ కాదు 100 degrees టెంపరేచర్ వరకు హీట్ చేసినా కూడా సాఫ్ట్ కాదు అదే రా రబ్బర్ అయినట్లయితే జస్ట్ టెంపరేచర్ డిక్రీజ్ అయినట్లయితే బ్రిటిల్ అవుతుంది టెంపరేచర్ హై అయినట్లయితే సాఫ్ట్ అవుతుంది కానీ వల్కనైజ్డ్ రబ్బర్ -40 degrees centigrade వరకు బ్రిటిల్ కాదు నెక్స్ట్ 100 degrees centigrade వరకు సాఫ్ట్ కాదు సో వర్కింగ్ టెంపరేచర్ ఈజ్ -40 degrees to 1000 degrees centigrade నెక్స్ట్ రెసిస్టెంట్ టు ఆర్గానిక్ సాల్వెంట్స్ లైక్ బెంజిన్ కార్బన్ టెట్రాక్లోరైడ్ ఎక్సెట్రా మనకు అదే రా రబ్బర్ని తీసుకున్నట్లయితే దట్ ఈస్ నాట్ రెసిస్టెంట్ టు ఆర్గానిక్ సాల్వెంట్స్ లైక్ బెంజిన్ కార్బన్ టెట్రాక్లోరైడ్ బట్ వల్కనైజ్డ్ రబ్బర్ ఈస్ రెసిస్టెంట్ టు ఆర్గానిక్ సాల్వెంట్స్ లైక్ బెంజిన్ కార్బన్ టెట్రాక్లోరైడ్ ఎక్సెట్రా. ఈ ఆర్గానిక్ సాల్వెంట్స్ రబ్బర్పై ఉన్న ఇలాంటి ఎఫెక్ట్ను జూయించు. నెక్స్ట్ హై రెసిస్టెంట్ టు ఆక్సిడేషన్, ఇది అంత ఈజీగా వల్కనైజ్డ్ రబ్బర్ ఆక్సిడైజ్ కాదు, H2SO4HNO3. నెక్స్ట్ ఎలాస్టిసిటీ డిపెండ్స్ ఆన్ ఎక్స్టెన్షన్ ఆఫ్ వల్కనైజేషన్, ఎలాస్టిసిటీ డిపెండ్స్ ఆన్ ఎక్స్టెన్షన్ ఆఫ్ వల్కనైజేషన్. మనం రబ్బర్ను స్ట్రెచ్ చేసినట్లయితే ఎక్కువ స్ట్రెచ్ అవుతుంది, ఆ స్ట్రెచ్చింగ్ ఫోర్స్ తీసేస్తే మళ్ళీ సేమ్ ఫార్మేషన్ లోపలికి వచ్చేస్తుంది. నెక్స్ట్ ఎక్సలెంట్ రెసిలెన్స్, దీస్ ఆర్ ద క్యారెక్టరిస్టిక్స్ ఆఫ్ వల్కనైజ్డ్ రబ్బర్. ఓకే, గుడ్ వల్కనైజ్డ్ రబ్బర్ హ్యాస్ గుడ్ టెన్సైల్ స్ట్రెంగ్త్, దట్ ఈస్ 2000 kg/cm². నెక్స్ట్ వల్కనైజ్డ్ రబ్బర్ హ్యాస్ లో వాటర్ అబ్జార్ప్షన్ కెపాసిటీ, ఇట్ ఈస్ బెటర్ ఎలక్ట్రికల్ ఇన్సులేటర్, ఇట్స్ వర్కింగ్ టెంపరేచర్ ఈస్ -40 to 100°C. నెక్స్ట్ రెసిస్టెంట్ టు ఆర్గానిక్ సాల్వెంట్స్ లైక్ బెంజిన్, కార్బన్ టెట్రాక్లోరైడ్ ఎక్సెట్రా. నెక్స్ట్ ఇట్ ఈస్ హైయర్ రెసిస్టెంట్ టు ఆక్సిడేషన్. నెక్స్ట్ ఎలాస్టిసిటీ డిపెండ్స్ ఆన్ ఎక్స్టెన్షన్ ఆఫ్ వల్కనైజేషన్. నెక్స్ట్ ఎక్సలెంట్ రెసిలెన్స్. కంపారిజన్ ఆఫ్ రా అండ్ వల్కనైజ్డ్ రబ్బర్ property, take three columns, one is property, another one is raw rubber, another one is vulcanized rubber. First one we take in the property tensile strength. Raw rubber tensile strength is 200 kg/cm³. Vulcanized rubber tensile strength 2000 kg/cm³. That means raw rubber pane 200 kg/cm² వెయిట్ నుంచిన వరకే తట్టుకోగలుగుతుంది. అదే వల్కనైజ్డ్ రబ్బర్ పైన 2000 kg/cm² ఉంచినా కూడా తట్టుకుంటుంది. సో వల్కనైజ్డ్ రబ్బర్ టెన్సైల్ స్ట్రెంగ్త్ ఈస్ వెరీ హై కంపేర్డ్ టు ద రా రబ్బర్. నెక్స్ట్ ఎలాంగేషన్ ఎట్ బ్రేక్. Raw rubber is 1200, vulcanized rubber is 800. That means it is easy to break out raw rubber, vulcanized rubber is easy to break out. So raw rubber is break easily, vulcanized rubber is not break easily. Next property, rapidity of retraction. Raw rubber is good, vulcanized rubber is very good. Rapidity of retraction, raw rubber is good, vulcanized rubber is very good. Next, water absorption. Next property, raw rubber is large, vulcanized rubber is small. That means raw rubber ni manam water lo munchesinatlayite ekko water ni absorb chestundi, vulcanized rubber ni ade water lo dip chesinatlayite chala takko water nu absorb chestundi. So water absorption for raw rubber is large, vulcanized rubber is small. Next, swelling in organic solvent, infinite, that is soluble, large but limited. That means raw rubber nu manam organic solvent lo unchinatlayite raw rubber anetundi organic solvent lo soluble avutundi ante manaku adi rubber ga undadu. Next, adhe vulcanized rubber nu organic solvents lo unchinatlayite adi soluble kaadu, అయినా చాలా తక్కువ అవుతుంది, అలాగే ఉండిపోతుంది. సో స్వెల్లింగ్ ఇన్ ఆర్గానిక్ సాల్వెంట్, రా రబ్బర్ ఈజ్ ఇన్ఫినిట్, దట్ మీన్స్ సాల్యుబుల్, వల్కనైజ్డ్ రబ్బర్ లార్జ్ బట్ లిమిటెడ్. దీస్ ఆర్ ద ప్రాపర్టీస్ రా రబ్బర్, వల్కనైజ్డ్ రబ్బర్. లిజన్ టెన్సైల్ స్ట్రెంగ్త్ 200 kg/cm³, వల్కనైజ్డ్ రబ్బర్ ఈజ్ 2000 kg/cm³. ఎలాంగేషన్ ఎట్ బ్రేక్, రా రబ్బర్ ఈజ్ 1200, వల్కనైజ్డ్ రబ్బర్ ఈజ్ 800. Rapidity of retraction, raw rubber is good, vulcanized rubber is very good. Water absorption capacity, raw rubber large, vulcanized rubber small. Swelling in organic solvent, raw rubber infinite, vulcanized rubber large but limited. Next, another properties, thickness, raw rubber marked, vulcanized rubber, slate. తరారపన్న మనం కొంత మరి స్లిమ్ గా దాన్ని చేయలేము అదే వల్కనైజ్డ్ రబ్బర్ అయితే స్లిమ్ గా మనం చేయొచ్చు సో థిక్నెస్ ఆఫ్ రారబ్బర్ ఇస్ మార్క్డ్ వల్కనైజ్డ్ రబ్బర్ ఇస్ స్లైట్ వర్కింగ్ టెంపరేచర్ రేంజ్ రారబ్బర్ ఇస్ 10 డిగ్రీ సెంటిగ్రేడ్ టు 60 డిగ్రీ సెంటిగ్రేడ్ దట్ మీన్స్ రారబ్బర్ 10 డిగ్రీ సెంటిగ్రేడ్ వద్ద బ్రిటిల్ అవుతుంది 60 డిగ్రీ సెంటిగ్రేడ్ వద్ద సాఫ్ట్ అవుతుంది నెక్స్ట్ వల్కనైజ్డ్ రబ్బర్ Working temperature range is minus 10 degrees to 100 degrees centigrade. That means vulcanized rubber is brittle at minus 10 degrees centigrade. Vulcanized rubber is soft at 100 degrees centigrade. Next, chemical resistance. Raw rubber is very poor. Vulcanized rubber is much better. That means raw rubber is oxidized by oxidized solvents like H2SO4, HNO3. Vulcanized rubber is not oxidized by H2SO4 and HNO3, etc. That means chemical resistance for raw rubber is very poor. Vulcanized rubber is much better. Next one, elasticity. Raw rubber very high, 300 to 1000 degree centigrade. Vulcanized rubber low, depending on degree of vulcanization. Elasticity raw rubber ki ekkuva untundi, vulcanized rubber ku anta ekkuva untundi. Okay, thickness for raw rubber is marked, vulcanized rubber is slight. Working temperature range, raw rubber is 10 degrees centigrade to 60 degrees centigrade. Vulcanized rubber is minus 10 degrees to 100 degrees centigrade. Next, chemical resistance for raw rubber is very poor. Next, vulcanized rubber is much better. Elasticity, raw rubber is very high, 300 to 1000 degrees centigrade. Next, vulcanized rubber is low depending on degree of vulcanization. Okay. Summarize this video lesson. What we have discussed in this video lesson, we learned about sources of rubber, different types of rubber, structure of isoprene and natural rubber. Okay. Next, we discussed also what is latex, collection of latex, treatment of latex, coagulation of latex, coagulants. Okay. Okay, next we also discuss vulcanization, process of vulcanization, structure of vulcanized rubber also. Okay, we discussed about vulcanization, process of vulcanization, structure of vulcanized rubber. Next, we also discussed about properties of raw rubber, properties of vulcanized rubber, comparison of raw and vulcanized rubber. Okay, we have discussed properties of raw rubber, properties of vulcanized rubber. Next, comparison of raw and vulcanized rubber. Next, we discussed about some multiple choice questions. What are the sources of rubber? A. Natural sources. B. Artificial sources. C. Both. D. None of the above. So, what are the sources of rubber? Natural sources, artificial sources, both, none of the above. Yeah, rubber available as a natural source and artificial source. So, our answer is both. That is C is the correct answer. What are the sources of rubber means natural sources and artificial source. So C is the correct answer for this question. Okay, next we discuss about another question. That is, natural rubber is A. Organic polymer, B. Inorganic polymer, C. Both, D. None. Already we have discussed natural rubber is organic polymer. So our answer is A. A is the correct answer. Okay, next another question. Rubber is a polymer of A. Neoprene, B. Isoprene, C. Ethylene, D. Butadiene. Rubber is a polymer of isoprene. What is the isoprene raised to methyl 1,3-butadiene? What is the formula of isoprene? C5H8. So rubber is a polymer of isoprene. So B is the correct answer. Rubber is a polymer of isoprene. B is the correct answer. Okay, next we take another question. Latex is solution, solid, milky, colloidal, liquid, none. Let we have discussed latex is milky, colloidal, liquid. Okay, latex is milky, colloidal, liquid. Our answer is C. Okay, generally latex is obtained from trees like Hevea brasiliensis. Okay, some tapping is done on the tree. Some milky colloidal liquid is obtained from tapped off tree. That is called latex. Next, another question. Which one of the following is a coagulant? A. Sulfuric acid. B. Acetic acid. C. Hydrochloric acid. D. None. Let's just we have discussed. Acetic acid is a coagulant. Acetic acid is a coagulant. Okay, after tapping of tree, latex is obtained, that is taken in the vessel. After that, we add coagulants like acetic acid or formic acid, then rubber particles can be coagulated. That's why acetic acid or formic acid are coagulants. Okay, here acetic acid is the answer, so B is the correct answer. B is the correct answer. Next question. The coagulation of latex forms A. Neoprene. Next coagulamin. Next PVC. Next polythene. The coagulation of latex forms coagulamin. Already just I have told. Latex is obtained from tree by tapping of tree. After obtaining of latex, coagulants like acetic acid or formic acid are added. Then rubber particles can be coagulated from latex. That is called coagulum. 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 So second is the answer. Okay, next we discuss another question, that is the element which is added in the process of vulcanization. A. Zinc. B. Aluminium. C. Carbon. D. Sulfur. So sulfur is added in the process of vulcanization, that is called vulcanization of rubber. When sulfur is added to the raw rubber, sulfur combines at the double bond of carbon at 110 to 140 degree centigrade, then the rubber will be vulcanized. That rubber is called vulcanized rubber. So answer is sulfur. So D is the correct answer. D is the correct answer. Okay, next question. The percentage of sulfur present in the vulcanized rubber. The percentage of sulfur present in the vulcanized rubber, that is 20 to 30%, 1 to 50%, 1 to 32%, 50 to 100%. That is 1 to 32%. The percentage of sulfur present in the vulcanized rubber is 1 to 32%. Okay. C is the correct answer. Generally, a tire rubber may contains 3 to 5% of sulfur. A battery case rubber contains 30% of sulfur. When sulfur quantity increases in the vulcanization, stiffness of vulcanized rubber also increases. Stiffness of vulcanized rubber also increases. That means the extent of stiffness of vulcanized rubber depends on amount of sulfur added. So C is the correct answer. Next question. As the percentage of sulfur increases, the stiffness of rubber, just I have told, increases. Okay. Yes, the tire rubber may contain 3 to 5% of sulfur, that is soft. The battery case rubber contains 30% of sulfur, that is very stiff compared to the tire rubber. So the percentage of sulfur increases, the stiffness of rubber also increases. So A is the correct answer. A is the correct answer. Next question. Vulcanization process is carried out at temperature range of, this is very, very important. Vulcanization process is carried out at temperature range of A, 10 to 20 degree centigrade, B, 30 to 100 degree centigrade, C, 50 to 100 degree centigrade, D, 110 to 140 degree centigrade. Just, you know that, that is 110 to 140 degree centigrade. Okay, vulcanization process is carried out at temperature range of 110 to 140 degree centigrade. So what is the vulcanization? The process of heating the raw rubber with sulfur at 110 to 140 degree centigrade is called vulcanization. The process of heating the raw rubber with sulfur at 110 to 140 degree centigrade is called vulcanization. The properties of vulcanized rubber depends on the amount of sulfur, the temperature at which vulcanization is carried out, next duration of vulcanization also. So 110 to 140 degree centigrade. So D is the correct answer. D is the correct answer. Then some questions are asked in the examination frequently. What we have discussed in this video lesson, that is, write a note on natural rubber. Another one, explain the processing of natural rubber from latex. Okay, write a note on natural rubber. Another one, explain the processing of natural rubber from latex. Next, write a note on natural rubber. Describe the structure of natural rubber. Write a note on natural rubber. Describe the structure of natural rubber. Next, another one. What is vulcanization? Explain vulcanization with equation. What is the vulcanization? The process of heating the raw rubber with sulfur at 110 to 140 degree centigrade is called vulcanization. Next, explain vulcanization with equation. When sulfur is added to raw rubber, sulfur combines at the double bond of carbon, then sulfur will be vulcanized, that is called vulcanized rubber. So in this video lesson, what are the important means? Definition of vulcanization. Next, preparation of natural rubber. Next, what is the formula? Next, characteristics of vulcanized rubber. Already we have discussed, vulcanized rubber has good tensile strength and extensibility. It has low water absorption capacity than non-vulcanized rubber. Vulcanized rubber is a better electrical insulator. It has much higher resistance to oxidation, wear and tear. It is resistant to organic solvents like petrol, benzene, etc., fats and oils. It has lower elasticity. Next, vulcanized rubber has excellent resilience. The article made from it regains the original shape after the deforming load is removed. The working temperature of vulcanized rubber increases from 10 to 60 degree centigrade to minus 40 to 100 degree centigrade. It is very easy to manipulate the vulcanized rubber to get the desired shape. It has only slight thickness. This is about the video class. Okay, thank you for the listening of this video lesson.